Yeah, for Hot Wheels collectors. Got some loose cars. I do have another big one. I'll save that for later, though. First up, a lot of Matchbox, but again, because they were in good condition. First up, we have the Chrysler Panel Cruiser. This is a very nice Matchbox. Beautiful gold with fake wood panel effect on the side there. I should bring that back, fake wood panel effects on the side of station wagons and SUVs. It's such a brilliant, iconic look. It's just one of those sort of funny things of yesteryear, like in the 70s and 80s. People thought it was a wood effect, but it wasn't. Still nice though. Next up we have the Lamborghini Diablo. Beautiful blue car this. Very nice blue version. With working part, has an opening boot, which is very cool to reveal the engine bay. Oop. Very basic sort of features. Has suspension as well, as you can probably tell, which does work very good. Very nice indeed. Lovely overall blue. Of course, the classic Lamborghini logo in the corner there. Very nice. Nice big old heavy metal body, metal base Matchbox. The Mercedes-Benz 300E from another country or possibly somewhere else, because it says underneath here, it says Matchbox INTL, which I presume is the abbreviation for international, but it has police written on it, but in a different country name, Polizia, or Plozizia. I don't know how on earth to pronounce that, not very good. Again, opening and closing doors on either side. Heavy car, this is pure metal. Metal body, metal base. That is a very heavy car. Speaking of even heavier cars, another metal body, metal base. We have the Ford Crown Victoria police car. Only one of these I left behind because it's all dented and dinged up. These ones seem to be in the more mintier version. There's the classic light bar on the top there. Again, heavy car. Look, that's pure metal body, metal base. Very heavy. Speaking of heavy, we have an even heavier vehicle, but purely because of its size. It is the... Oh, it doesn't even say on this one. Oh, it's a 1998 Matchbox. Oh, there it is in the back there. Couldn't quite see it. Ford box truck. It is a Ford box truck. No idea on the logo. Might be from some play set. Possibly even just acts as a good double. On the side it's got OS7620-04. It's not my PIN number or anything. That's just what is written there. Some random numbers that somebody wrote in. It's a heavy model purely because it's a metal body. I presume if Matchbox ever wanted to bring this back, they would have to make it into a plastic body because of the sheer weight volume. But then again, they might release it as a metal body. I don't know, Matchbox. Another Ford Crown Victoria. More lighter version because it's plastic bodied. Metal body and plastic base. Nice red bar on the top. One for Race Crew's red, white and blue collection. It has the police logo on the side. Very nice blue bodied with white stripe and red signings on. Very nice indeed. One that might be going in the trade box. I'm not 100% if I do have this one. It's the 70 Plymouth AAR Cuda. I might already have this one. I think I have it in blue. I think I do have it in orange. I'm just not 100%, that's all. And I'll have to check condition-wise. Again, only slight bit of damage is just on the corner there. Two very, very minute little chips. But again, other than that, absolutely mint conditioned. Beautiful colour, orange. On the back, it's just got CUDA written on it. Shame my camera don't focus very well. But on the back there, it just says CUDA. Very nice indeed. The other one that might be up for trades as well is this Fandango Enforcer, the Enforcer. I think I might have this one, I think it might be a wheel variation. Not 100% on that. nice overall colour. Well, it might be a case of the sides are all worn and this one's a lot better conditioned. Very nice to have that one. Another slightly older Matchbox. It's the Armoured Truck. It's a Matchbox Superfast from 1978. It certainly is a very nice old armoured truck. Slight bit of damage on the roof there, and the light bar, blue light, has been cut off. It has been cut off, it hasn't been snapped off or broken off, it has been cut off, so I presume someone's probably gone, what was that, in the middle of the night and decided to cut that off so they get at least a bit smoother on the foot. Again, metal bodied, metal base. Not that heavy though, I mean, compared to the other two, it's actually quite a lightweight. I think that's because they have saved on weight due to the fact that there is no interior. It is literally just the glass. Plastic glass, and that's it. That's where they've saved a bit of money. They removed the interior. Common thing that happened back in the early 80s with Matchbox is they removed the interior and just basically put a plastic piece of glass in there, all dark glass, so you couldn't even see into it unless you opened it up. We now have a Chevrolet Impala. Now this is the other one, like Ford we've just had. This is a test mission car. It's got the police sirens on top, the proper sort of like 7-bar one. I think there's 7 lights on there. Yep, 7 lights. Very beautifully done. Nice bit of plastic. Light as well, metal bodied, plastic base. Very good indeed. One for the DC TV crew, because I know one of them likes the big rigs. Have a 1982 Kenworth racing rig. This has the spoiler on the back. Very popular back in the day was to race big rigs. Late 80s, I think, Front Runner Video, copyrighted Front Runner. They usually made a lot of videos and they had sort of like the super trucks. Slight bit of damage on the side there, as you can see. Been chipped off. Other than that though, it's all in good condition. Green glass as well. That's interesting. Oh, that's going to show up. Yeah. Green glass. Not that uncommon, but very nice indeed. Cool Ferrari F40 from Matchbox. Found this one in a Newmarket charity shop. Very nice indeed. Beautiful Ferrari logo on the front there. Which does just say Ferrari. Slight little bit of damage in the rear end. Spoiler has been slightly bent, probably it's been pressed on in the middle. Again, like I say, thin metal, and that was so easy to bend back in the day. But again, it's also got on the side Filomena or Filorament, something like that. Something written in Italian that I can't quite read, and my camera can't pick up. Also as well for Charlie A, or Charlie C, or Charlie, guy who likes the big vans, I think it's called, not the super van, the other one, the truck. Got this one here, very nice old original truck. It's got Grave Rave on it, written on the side. I think it's from 2002, 2003, or 2001, or 90s. I seem to remember the La Trucca seemed to have the same sort of design on it. Very nice though. With opening doors, I think the only reason why Mattel has closed the doors now is because they don't exactly open up straight. They more open up a little bit drunk, shall we say. Then we have the 64 Lincoln Continental. Soft top, not the hard top. This is the older soft top. Beautiful lime green with some very nice pinstriping on the side. Nothing on the hood, but on the back it has a beautiful emblem which says Hot Wheels on it. Very cool, cool emblem design. Very nice indeed. Now then, request to all collectors and everything Hot Wheels, toy car or anything related that has been collecting for a very long time or knows what rare stuff is. This next item is from Mattel. It doesn't have Hot Wheels, Matchbox, or anything on it. It just has Mattel. Now, I know Mattel did a lot of other stuff like Barbie, He-Man, and other various things, but this one screams out Hot Wheels, but doesn't seem to have anything related to it. Well, here it is. Now, what I first thought was, ooh, colour changer. That's odd. It doesn't look Hot Wheels, though. If you look at the wheels, though, they do seem to have Hot Wheels-esque type wheels. And these are rubber wheels on the back here. Front ones are plastic. These are rubber wheels because, look, see? They come off. They come off slightly. So those are definite rubber wheels. The other thing as well is the fact that underneath, I thought it was originally a pull-back-and-go car. Because if you look at most pull-back-and-go cars, they have a little area where the motor can fit in. But it doesn't. And I've had this apart to clean it. There's a screw hole there. Again, all it has on it is Mattel Inc. 1988, and it has Arco China. So I've no idea if that was a sideline company that failed. I've no idea if this was a prototype colour changer. Could have been, because to me it looked like it was a real nice colour changer. But what distinctive of me was, I was thinking sort of like 1932 delivery van, because it had that distinctive stripe on the side. Now, I know a delivery van in the smaller scale vehicles had that sort of stripe. Again, absolutely no idea on the name, the age, or what on earth makes it. But again, it definitely has on the bottom here, Mattel Inc. 1988 Arco China. My camera probably won't show it. There you can definitely see Arco. And on that little top bit there, is Mattel Inc. 1988. So again, any information, anything at all on this vehicle will be really good. And this isn't sort of like a small-scale vehicle. No, no. That's the size comparison. That's the bigger one. That's the normal mainline version. Definitely a lot bigger, as you can see. So again, any information on that vehicle, greatly accepted, because I've no idea what on earth it is. It's very nice, though. So that will be one of those ones that if you know what it is, do please comment, because I don't know what on earth it is. I just grabbed it because I thought it was Hot Wheels related. I don't know. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time for some carded jukebox series. See ya.